Hello, students. This is Sahime Önce. For the Accounting 1 course, today we'll talk about the Chapter 1, Accounting and Business Environment. But you know, this first chapter is very important to understand the importance of accounting and why you should learn accounting. And we'll explain the most important parts. Therefore, I divide it to three parts, what you learn in chapter one. In the first part of the chapter one, you'll identify the activities and information users, and you can explain the ethical behavior, measurement principles, and basic assumptions. So we'll have two title on the first part, accounting information, and ethical behavior measurement principles and basic assumptions. When we talk about accounting, and we can call as a financial accounting sometimes shortly accounting, same thing. Accounting concentrates on the way of producing and reporting financial information. Because if you are talking about the accounting, there must be a business entity. So knowing the accounting will be helpful to make effective and efficient decisions in the company or related to business entity. Therefore, we call the accounting as a language of business. If you are in the business entity, you have to learn this language, because accounting will provide financial information to all information users or to all interested parties, such as owners or managers. Managers or owners will need those financial information, because operating a business requires a lot of information and decisions. For example, what will be the inventory volume? What will be the price of the product? How many people or employees will work in the company? Will we get debt or not? All of them are related to business decisions. And to give the right decision, we'll need some information. Accounting will provide those information to the decision makers. And all in the company, in the business entity, business decisions will produce financial results, which are critical to understand the performance and financial situation of the company. So we have to keep in track of financial transactions. This is the very essential for the companies to make effective and efficient decisions. Therefore, we can define the accounting as an information system which provides financial information about the entity for the decision makers. This definition you'll learn in this chapter one. And in accounting process, there are three main activities. In the first activity, we will identify the events. So we called it as identifying process. In the second process, recording or measuring. This process includes recording, classifying, and summarizing. And in the last process, last step, we have to communicate all the information with the decision makers. Therefore, financial statements and reports must be prepared. And who will use the accounting information? We can classify it as an internal and external users. Internal users are managers of the company, and they will need very detailed information about the company. As you can see on the screen, for example, they will ask, oh, can we afford the raise minimum salaries, wages? And what price should be charged in order to maximize company's net income? Which product line is the most profitable? So managers are responsible to make plan, organize, and run the business. Therefore, managers are the most important group of internal users. But there are some external users. External users can be individuals, other business entities, or organizations outside the company. For example, investors, creditors, taxing authorities, government, customers, consumers, suppliers, they are external users. And primary external users are investors and creditors because they have a direct financial interest in a business. So we have to satisfy their information needs. So we will use the, or we have to use different branches of accounting. For example, if you are focusing on the information needs of external information users, financial accounting. But managerial accounting will focus on the information needs of internal users, especially managers. During this textbook, we'll focus on the external information users' needs, so financial accounting part. Therefore, at the beginning, I told you financial accounting or accounting. If you don't mention, if you're just using accounting, we mean financial accounting. For the managerial accounting, you have to emphasize it. And information, financial information is very important in the decision-making process. Therefore, financial information must be sufficient, useful, and understandable. Therefore, accountants will follow some certain rules, principles, assumptions, and standards in the financial accounting process. But it will not be enough. Beside the those specific rules, quality of financial information will depend on the ethical behavior of individuals. Therefore, ethics are very important in accounting. As you know, when we talk about the ethics, ethics are the humanly devised rules, procedures, and norms to judge one's action as right or wrong, honest or dishonest, and fair or not fair. In this sense, identifying one's action as ethical, that action must be right, honest, and fair. And also, accounting standards are important. Those standards are a set of principles and rules that companies follow when they prepare and publish their financial statements, providing a standardized way of describing the company's financial performance so users can compare different companies' financial statements. So accounting standards are very important. So in all over the world, generally accepted, globally accepted accounting standards are issued by International Accounting Standards Board. We call them as an International Financial Reporting Standards. And principles, measurement principles are important. When we talk about the measurement, it refers to valuation of assets and liabilities in accounting process. What will be the value of the asset or liability? And according to the standards, we'll use two different measurement or principle. One of them is historical cost principle. The other one is fair value principle. And also, we have to make some assumptions. For the conceptual framework, those assumptions are very important. One of the most important assumptions is monetary unit assumption. All events, or I mean, if any event can be explained in monetary value, that event is subject to accounting. Economic entity assumption. Economic entity is a separate unit. And going concern assumption, it says that company will live forever. So at the beginning, we have to know those assumptions. And in the second part of this chapter, you'll learn for the basic accounting equation.